Hi, I'm Rachel, and this video is going to show a variation on a hip kangaroo that can be used as a burp hold. I'm going to start with the middle marker of my wrap on baby's back. This can be done with a base size or base minus one, maybe even base minus two. This is a base minus two and it can barely tie it off. So, middle marker is in the middle of baby's back. I'm leaning backward. I'm going to make baby a seat. Notice that baby's bottom is actually on top of my chest. So I'm making that seat all the way up on top of my chest. I'm gonna take the wrap in my hand with the bottom edge in my hand, flip the bottom edge toward my neck, and the top edge coming snug to the outside of my shoulder, making sure to get this arm in. I'm gonna let that shoulder flip, just sit there for a second. This side is gonna come under my arm, trying to get as much of baby's shoulder as I can in, but if baby wants an arm out, that's okay too. Baby will still be really well supported on your shoulder even with one arm out. So I'm gonna bring this side across my back, being careful not to pin that little leg in there. All right, nice and snug across my back. I'll hold that for a minute, and then I'm gonna bring this top shoulder across my back as well, grabbing the blue edge. Oops. Grab the blue edge first. And I'm going to snug that up, take a second to get my shoulder nice and comfortable with that top edge out to the edge of my shoulder. I'll do a little tightening through that shoulder by shrugging back and pulling forward on each strand of the wrap. Here we go. Pull this whole tail tight, pull that whole tail tight. Okay, now I'm going to reinforce this. I'm taking the one from behind my back over one leg, and then under the other, and I'll pin that one in the back. The one coming across my chest, I'm gonna bring all the way across his back, straight across, making a horizontal pass, straight from knee to knee. And then I'll take that and tie snugly behind us, making sure not to pin this little knee in there. Here we go. And I'll tie a double knot in the back. And there I have a pretty nice burp hold, and I can at least make a sandwich or something while holding a cranky baby. One thing I love the most about this carry is that if he falls asleep in the burp hold and I don't actually want him in a burp hold any longer, I can loosen my knot in the back and then just lean forward and just kind of shift him centered on my body. Sometimes there's a little tightening to do there, so you may have to retie the knot and tighten just that horizontal pass. So let me do that really quickly. And then you're back with like a reinforced hip kangaroo, which works out really comfortably as well. All right, thanks. I hope that helps you through some cranky baby days. We've had our share over here these days. All right, thanks. Bye.